ghosts, do they really exist? Yes, they do exist, but not in the way shown in Hollywood or Bollywood. Before we talk about their existence, it's very important for you to know few things like what is ghost, why they become ghosts, can they be harmful? Coming to the point, although ghosts are very real, they are always completely harmless. Ghosts is after all quite simply a totally normal but a deceased human being living within a more subtle body. But after death, for some reason, they become trapped in the lowest part of the etheric plane, closest to the physical world. Let's make it more simple. See, many of you know or at least have heard about OBE, out of body experience, NDE, near death experience, or an astral traveler. If you don't know, then I'll leave a link in the description so that you know what is OBE, out of body experience. In fact, the only difference between the ghost and a person in OBE state is that an out of body traveler can return to their physical body, whereas a ghost cannot. Ghosts are generally not monstrous, malicious, or even particularly mysterious. They are simply recently deceased, disembodied soul lingering around the physical plane. After someone's death, the silver cord that connect astral traveler to their physical bodies, that life essence is severed and the disembodied consciousness can no longer return. The Bible even mentioned this in Ecclesiastes 12:6-7. Remember him before the silver cord is severed or golden bowl is broken, before the pitcher is shattered at the spring or wheel broken at the well, and dust returned to the ground it came from, and the spirit returned to God who gave it. Now let's see why they become ghosts. Adrian Cooper wrote in his book named Ultimate Reality, page number 161, there are many reasons why deceased soul fail to smoothly transition from out their bodies and physical plane. Some people dying from sudden accident, murder or heart attack, for example, do not realize they have passed on. Other people simply do not accept that they have died and cannot return to the physical, and some are so attached to the material world and addiction like sex and power that they refuse to move on, while some are attached to relationship responsibilities or harbor guilt and they feel must be reconciled. Often a departed loved one will try to manifest sign to show that they have not ceased to be. When we are operating on the other dimension, if you don't know what is dimension, I'll leave a link in the description. The easiest way to have an influence in this world is via electrical equipment through a vibrational connection that affect electrical circuitry. People stop watches by projecting their thoughts because thoughts are electrical and vibrational phenomena, hence brainwave. Such thought wave can also project it from other dimension into this one and have a similar effect. And when this happens, people will often say that this place is haunted. It is for this reason that there are so many stories of ghosts that haunt location where they once lived. When the soul of a deceased person remain in a particular locality, a house for example, a soul is known as ghost and the location inhabited by the ghost is considered to be haunted. To a physical person living in a haunted house, the ghost will often seems to carry out exactly the same series of action every time it make an appearance, often at the same physical time of day or night. For example, stepping on a creaky floorboard, walking up the stairs, moving item around, and even switching lights and other electrical appliances on and off. This is possible when the ghosts achieve the necessary density approaching that of the physical world by absorbing large amount of etheric energy from their surrounding sufficient to influence the density of physical objects. Several surveys have been taken during the past century in Great Britain and United States, which have concluded that between 10 and 27% of general population claim to have at least once in their life a sensory perception, often visual, of another person who was not physically present, i.e. ghosts. Some people think it's bullshit, ghosts don't exist. Then why so many outstanding researchers, such as the famous physicist Sir William Crookes, the Nobel Prize winning physician and psychologist Sir Charles Richard, Sir Oliver Lodge, etc., would have invested so much time and energy in the field with no real phenomena to observe. I have so many research stories from different books, but due to the lack of time, cause no one like long video, I'm going to share one that I like. A very famous British psychic medium named Gordon Smith. He told of a particular case that he had been involved with. A woman named Sally had come to see him in a great distress to ask if he could help her find her missing son without providing any information about her son. Smith was able to contact her son, who told him that his name was Blake and what his mother would find out she wouldn't like. A message was sadly true. He went on to say that he had been a soldier training in France when, after a night out, he had been accidentally killed. He described to Smith the river where his body now lay. All the personal details were correct. A year later, a human thigh bone was found in the exact same place where Blake told Smith he would be. And when the DNA was tested, it proved to belong to Sally's dead son. Interesting, right? So there's nothing to be scared of ghosts. They are totally harmless. To understand this subject in more deep, you must know about reincarnation. Reincarnation is a different subject. If I have a good response in this video, I'm surely going to make my next video on reincarnation. For now, it's the end of the video. Thank you so much for your precious time you have spent watching my video. See you on my next video.